Hi, this is Rich. Welcome to my blog. Agvila and I are going to talk about entities and some things you can do to keep them from getting into your space. Just some tips and tricks and things like that as we discuss the subject in general. And we're doing this because Agvila and I are doing a lot of entity work on each other. We're learning new things, and we want to share with you the nature of entities. And this is kind of advanced stuff. About 40 years ago, when I first, 30 years ago, when I first heard about this sort of thing, it was a requirement that I do a lot of other kind of spiritual work. So I'm ready for this. Like, hang on to your fucking ass, because this shit's going to blow you away if you're not prepared. So just a little kind of a warning or a little thing. This might be a little bit unnerving. Yeah. Or a lot, if you watch this sort of thing. But before we get started, I offer some courses at richwest.net. That entity handling is a couple of entity handling techniques there. And you can learn more about the entity phenomena. And you can also get rid of entity issues by doing soul contract revocations. In other words, we've made agreements somehow that allow these entities to interact with us. Sometimes it's very obscure, and sometimes just revoking some agreements doesn't fix it, but these are some tools and things that you can use over at richwest.net. Also, there's an out-of-body travel training course there that will help you different kinds of techniques and approaches for getting out-of-body, a little beyond the normal.
Yeah.
These things can help you with your entity stuff too, because being able to get out of body, you can see them directly and clearly. So there's just a whole lot that we're going to talk about. Let me ask Agvila, we're going to interview each other and get kind of going. Okay. So here we go. What are some of the things you've learned recently? What have you been doing recently that has brought your awareness up on the subject, and how you've learned more about the entity phenomena and how it affects you and other people? What have you been doing recently?
Well, you know, it all started with me mentioning one word since 7 years ago. Like, we were talking, and I would mention this, I feel like I'm broken. I would give that, you break the glass and it's never going to be the same. You fold the paper, it's never going to be the same. So it felt like that's what people were doing with me. They were breaking me, and I was like a whole different person. And recently, a few weeks ago, when I've mentioned this to you, you've mentioned that phenomenon where you can get shattered into parts and lose aspects of yourself. So that's when we started doing sort of work, and I found out that over the years, since I was born, and everything that happened through my life, I was losing different aspects of myself. I was losing the strong ones that were helping me, supporting me, and making my life better. And that changed me, and I became weaker, my life is harder and stuff. So, we've been doing this sort of work, finding other aspects of me, working with entities and getting rid of them, removing the agreements, various things. They're just a lot.
Yeah, we started doing soul retrieval work. On the soul contract revocation course, there's a step in there. After you break the agreements or revoke the agreements, there's a process where you can then start retrieving soul fragments, aspects of yourself that got caught up, involved in that agreement. Now the agreement is revoked. That aspect of yourself is free, but it might be lost, in some other plane, in the past, alternate reality, or alternate time track.
Yeah.
It gets real deep, but there's a way to do soul retrieval or soul fragment retrieval, fixing the splintered aspects of self when they got splintered and lost. And this can happen over millions and billions of years. Bits and pieces of get splintered and fractured, and this is what we've got left. So there's these techniques and processes that we're using together. We're using a meter that reads psychic energy. Thought energy, and it's kind of helping us do this. So, yeah. Okay. So now I have another question for you.
Sure.
What are some of the things that you've noticed recently about entities that maybe you didn't know before, or it's like, or confirms your suspicions about entities in the big picture?
Well, you know, like I've always had a suspicion, like, hey, like they're setting it up, or like it's, I thought like, you know, like they're messing with people, but then after doing sort of work, like, damn, you realize how big it is and how vast the subject of entities messing with people. Because with the work we've been doing, like I've mentioned that I've been to their bases and the undergrounds, like where they had like tons of servers, computers, and technologies. And literally, you look at the screens and they're following every single human being on Earth. And they know absolutely everything about us, our age, our height, everything about our body inside out. Because like they have entities inside our body that can scan every single thought, all the energies, every single cell. They know absolutely everything that's going on inside us. So they know when to trigger the headache, when to trigger specific in your body, cause certain feelings, trigger your emotions, like make you more like on steroids or like more reactive. They can do that. And they can control outer forces. They know that, okay, this is what you want to do. We're going to affect other people around you to make sure that you're not going to do that. Because you as a person are like, you can handle that various situations, but you're not that good when something like there are people around you. So you're not good at relationships. They're going to make sure that they target relationships because that's where you're weak. So they know your buttons, they know your weak spot, and they're pretty much using everything against us. You know, once they know our plans and what we're going for, they're going to make sure that they can stop us and using their own little ways. But damn, like, it's really big and like really deep. Like, I felt like, you know, they're controlling us in some sort of ways, but that much? Like, damn, that's really a lot.
Yeah, it's amazing. Speechless. The technology that exists today regarding smart dust, for example, this is programmable nanoparticles. It's very advanced technology, but you can, you know, do some research on it. What smart dust is all about? Why is it smart? What's about it that's smart? And other chemtrail particles, particulates, nanoparticles. They get into the air. We breathe it in. Now these nanoparticles, now they become used by the body when the body's trying to rebuild its cellular structure. Let's say it's going to rebuild some blood cells or bone cells, and it would normally grab a little micro bit of chromium or zinc or something, just a little bit of iron or something. But now it's got these foreign particles, programmable smart dust, and your body will grab that particle and use it as a building block in your cellular structure, whether it's in your brain or your bones, it doesn't matter where it is. But this sort of technology exists today with current modern scientific nanotechnology stuff. Okay, now imagine what it would be like if extraterrestrial advanced civilizations that are also extra-dimensional, multi-dimensional, they can move in and out of this plane. They have this technology and they've been building on it for millions of years.
Yeah.
It's advanced. Are they using it? Has Earth been invaded? Is there an alien invasion force already? Wow, I just got dizzy. Fuck.
You're picking up on it.
Yeah. Is there an alien invasion force currently on Earth active doing what they do to humanity? The answer is yes. I highly recommend Wes Penray and his website. He has a lot of research on this subject, but so many others do as well. So part of this alien invasion approach is using advanced technology and what we call entities, like an extraterrestrial, let's say a gray, that is operating in the non-physical realm. You can call it the lower astral or the third, fourth density, whatever you want to call that realm that they are in. Sometimes you can wake up in the middle of the night and you see a gray in your room. What the hell are you doing here? Or you wake up in the middle of the night and you're on some spaceship. You don't know if it's a dream, a lucid dream, an out-of-body experience, are a freaking abduction and physical. You can't tell, but there you are, and it's real as can be. It's really happening. Those are entities. There's all kinds of entities. Reptilians are the Graves' bosses, generally. AI is involved. There's all kinds. And there's the demons, and there's the thought form entities. There's just all kinds. So this is what we're talking about. We're talking about entities, and we're learning more about this with the research and work we're doing. And what we're doing is learning new techniques for getting the entities out of your space, so you're not as affected as much by entities. So that's me talking again. Back to you, Akvila. What are some of the strategies or techniques you've been using to get these out of your space? Or is there something else you would like to share with people who, and now that we've got their attention, about it?
Well, a few things. Like, I'm going to answer your question, the first one. Basically, the way like I deal with entities is, one, spotting them, because that alone scares them. And they're like, oh my god, like, then they run away. Of course, with the OMG word, but, you know, like, they have the reaction and they get away because they don't want to be destroyed or whatever. So they just get away, like, they're scared, so they want to be there. Other aspects, like, you know, or other ways to do it is threaten them. You know, you just have your rules, and they do not, like, they're weaker than us. So we have all the power, and we can give them rules, and if they agree to it, then they, like, just go away and do other things, or if they don't, then you'll have to deal with them differently. And, you know, lots of ways, killing them, sending them love, reprogramming them, sending them into different realms so that they wouldn't be there and they couldn't get out and stuff. Like, lots of ways to handle them. And one of the amazing things that I've discovered, or, like, that was interesting to me, is that once I'm dealing with entities, and if I'm able to touch them, like, let's say if I engage in fighting, and, for example, I'm fighting some sort of reptilian or whatever, and, like, just destroying their ship, and I touch the ship or whatever, whatever I touch basically gives me the memory. Like, it's really instant, it's, like, really fast, but I get the memory of everything that happened. How the ship was created, where was it created, who created it, everyone in the ship, every single being in their entity, all their memories and their past. And it's like, it should be overwhelming for me, but I think it's overwhelming here in the physical for this body. But out there, you can, like, have everything, no matter how big or funny it is. Like, it can be traumatic, hardcore, gory and stuff. And that's like, you know, you just get that information, not the reaction to it. You wouldn't have the same reaction on Earth, I think. But the amazing part is that, you know, with everything that I'm doing there, when I encounter entities getting their past, I get the information and know what happened, where they are, where they're located, their bases, their connections, you know, who they're talking to, dealing with, who they're affecting. I get it all, and it's, like, really amazing, because we have sort of experiences, like you're guiding me and stuff, and I would deal with entities, and I come back with the bag of information, but I've never read about it on Earth. So I'm talking to you about it, and you confirm it that you read it somewhere, or you have the knowledge about it. And I'm like, wow, I've never heard it, I never read it, I've learned it over there from other entity, and it matches with you and other people. Like, that's great, you know. So for me, it's like learning, getting information, and coming back, and that's, like, working. So it's pretty amazing.
Yeah, it's when you get agreement, you know. Oh, I agree. Yeah, I've seen that too, or I've heard of that too, or I read about that too. That agreement creates reality. It makes it more real. Like, oh my God, this must be real. You know, not just my imagination sort of thing. And that's what reality is a common agreement. And so what we're doing here with this video, and we might do more like this, is to bring people's awareness up of the phenomena, so that if you've experienced things, or you had intuition or hunch or feelings about these sort of things, or encounters with these sort of things, you can go, I agree. That stuff's real. Maybe not physical, but it's real. They do interact with us in the non-physical realms, in the mental, with our mental stuff and emotional stuff. And some people, some of you viewers, you're psychic, you have clairvoyance, you have extremely high visual skills, visualization skills. Your imagination is extremely vivid. These things are clues that you will have the ability to see these kind of entities directly while you're dealing with them. You can look at them, and if you know the techniques and strategies for communicating with them, what to say to them, what to expect from them, and how it is that they have seemingly have power over you, what you can do about it, and you learn their tips, their tricks, and their methods for confusing us, confounding us, making us feel bad, and giving us thoughts that are not our own, these sort of things. As you learn more about this, you become more able to deal with the entity issue, which is huge. This is archons, this is reptilians, this is greys, either demons, the kind of demons you hear about in the different religions, being demon possessed or cursed, all this stuff, ghosts, poltergeists. This is all involved in the same stuff. But what's to know, and it's a little bit advanced, and should we even be talking about this to you guys, is that it's more serious than people think. But once you get attuned to it and you start learning techniques for dealing with these sort of things, you know, you can start shaking them off, spotting them. Like Akvila said, a lot of them will just take off running if they're spotted, because these things like to work in secret. We are more powerful than they are. We have the ability to imagine in the realm where they live and exist. We can manifest things with a thought. We're like beings with superpowers. Akvila's one of her superpowers is she can touch an object and see its past. But there's all kinds of superpowers that people have, the ability to shrink things down into a micro dot. It could be a big entity. You can shrink it down like this. You can blow it up. You can turn it into a little fluffy animal from, you know, ugly reptilian. They don't like when you do that to them. They don't like it, but they can't do anything about it. You can blow the shit out of them. There's lots of things you can do if you know you can do it. If you don't believe you can do it, then you've got programming and limited beliefs programmed within you, and you can look at like who did that, when and how. So it becomes partly entity work and partly past life work, and you're doing work between multidimensional or interdimensional work and healing on yourself. And Akvila's, you know, she's reaching out and she starts dealing with entity stuff that is affecting others. So she's doing healing work on others. It's all this sort of thing. And I go, what the fuck? Let's do a video just me and her talking about this. You guys still with us? Too creepy? You okay? All right.
I think it was interesting how the other day we were targeting the AI and I took it down. And then the next day you watched the video and someone's talking how AI was taken down.
Yeah. What a synchronicity that was.
Yeah.
There's a lady, the Yellow Rose of Texas is her YouTube. Maybe I don't subscribe to everything, you know, her whole story in the big picture, but a lot of it is, I do. I can totally relate to a lot of what she's sharing. So, Agbila was doing some stuff, and I asked her to spot the AI involved, and she did. And she followed it around the whole network of it, and she blew the shit out of it. Like the next day or two later, I'm getting a video, two or three days later, I'm getting a video and another lady is saying that the AI was taken out. Now I'm sure there's more than one AI and I don't know which one she was talking about. I don't know which one you were dealing with, but gee, what a coincidence. And yes, we can take out that artificial intelligence. It has like, it's like an internet, galactic internet sort of reach, and it's very sophisticated. You just think about the cloud here with the current technology and how it's data mining, gathering all this information on each individual. LifeLog was a CIA program. It was canceled the same day Facebook came online. Same stuff. Some lady that was in the LifeLog program, what a coincidence. She's now in the executive branch of the Facebook thing, data collection, mining, monitoring every individual. Take that to the next level of advanced races of predatory reptilian type extraterrestrials who are out to consume everything.
Yeah.
Think of their technology, what they might have out there. And they probably do. And this is the sort of things that Ogvila and I have been addressing. And Ogvila's been blowing shit up, man.
Pretty much.
Do you want to tell them about that, a little more details about the AI you tracked down? Where it started with a not AI, and then it kind of tapped into AI, and then you went into that thing?
With so many AIs that we've dealt with, like, which one are you talking about?
I don't know. Make something up. No. I remember one, it started out with you were tracking, maybe it was a gray or a reptilian in a spacecraft. So she's seeing the whole spacecraft. She can scan through, it's like an out-of-body experience. She's going through the entire spacecraft. Is that right?
Yeah. I look at the spacecraft and I can see what, like, you know, I see a spacecraft in the distance, and just like that, I see through the walls. I see every single room. I see every single being in there. Every single detail. Like, I can zoom in and check out, like, even dust in the floor, or I can zoom out and, like, see everything. Like, it's pretty fun.
The texture of their skin, what they look
everything.
Like?
Absolutely everything.
Could you smell them if you...
I could.
I know most people don't tune into that and they don't really recall that, but you could if you zoomed in.
Yeah, pretty much.
Touch their skin and feel what if it's oily or dry or any...
Ooh. Yeah.
That's... And vivid, it's like watching, it's more, it's like 3D holographic virtual reality, or like real as real, or what the fuck?
Real as can be. Real as can be.
I got that dizzy feeling thing going. So yeah, Ogvila has these super abilities, like the super visual, it's like a wide awake out of body experiences, kind of like that. Yeah, is that kind of like what it is? So that's what she's doing. And we finally, we've been working together and doing stuff together for about over 6 years. And we started with Ubi out of body stuff, but we kind of got sidetracked. But just recently, hey, let's get back into this with the entity stuff. So with the entity stuff is leading us to these non-physical, but very real planes and dimensions and densities, where Ogvila is tracking these entities that are messing with her emotionally or mentally in some way, slowing her down or stopping her, making her feel wrong, bad, guilty, or he's fucked up or something. And so we're going after those things. And we're finding with this one in particular, it was, I think, some grays involved. They had their reptilian boss or something. But while you were on that spaceship, you noticed they had an AI system. And it went back to this huge planet. That's the one I'm talking about.
Okay.
Can you tell that little story?
Yeah. So, you know, as we were doing sort of work, and I found, like, those grays ended up with them and found their boss, and, like, and as I destroy the spaceship, I, you know, like, Rich tells me, like, to destroy AI, and I'm like, okay, so I got it. And all of a sudden, I pick up that AI is, like, escaping. So it's, like, it's not going to, like, disappear anymore. It's just going to be in another place. So I'm following that AI, and there's a whole fleet. And that fleet, like, 64 spaceships, they're all targeting humanity, all, like, everyone's directing their guns and everything, and basically they're creating this holographic shield around Earth so that they wouldn't be detected. It's like basically I think it's like invisibility cloak so that they wouldn't be seen. So it's like we look at the stars, like, oh, cool stars, we don't see them. Like that's because, like, they have those holographic shields, and, like, for them it's like full coverage. And they also have as I said, they have, like, huge network around Earth where they're, like, targeting people, causing negative things, like, whatever incident can happen, like, you know, these killings, bombings, you know, just basically triggering people in any sort of way, all the negativity they can get, they're creating that luge, and literally you see that, like, tons, like, you see, like, huge, fat strings coming out of Earth into those ships where they're gathering all that luge to feed them, and it's, like, it's really big. And so I, like, destroyed the whole fleet of those ships. I destroyed the holographic shields. I call out, like, other guys I knew, like, you know, the spaceship with the boss that I used to work with, like, the first time when I saw him. So I, like, call those guys in, like, we had the good guy fleet, and, like, I'm just, like, watching. There's, like, literally, like, Star Wars, like, everyone's shooting each other, and there's, like, huge space opera going on, like, wow, like, and there's a huge laser, like, going through, and I'm like, whoa, that was close, you know? It's, like, super real. Yeah, and And dealing with all that, and I go and like, you know, there's like a planet and like their underground bases. Like that's where I found those servers that were like they're tracking everyone on Earth. There's like tens of beings that I've never seen. Like they're freaking tall, like 30, 40 meters tall, huge, fat, like a sticky mantis or whatever, but like different. I just don't know how to describe it, but I could draw it, but like they're weird as can be. And you know, like they're walking in, like you see literally there's a place where, you know, beings can teleport, and like they're in the base and they're walking, and some coming in and out, like they're like, it's just like a how should I say, like a bay for some, or just like that point of traveling from one point to another. So, you know, that's their place.
Yeah, Nexus point, a terminal, a bay, a portal.
Pretty much. Yeah.
Something like that.
Yeah. So, like, you know, like various beings, and I found this network of, you know, AI and like servers and everything tracking everyone on Earth. And I'm like, as I'm exploring their underground bases, I find this room that goes for miles and miles and miles to every direction. And like there's tons of pods where people are in, like humans are in those pods, and they're being harvested, their blood, their plasma, their gold, everything. And they like literally decapitating us in parts, and like some are eating us, some are like using us as sex toys, some are using like us for DNA and just playing genes and stuff. And there's like tons of things going on. I'm like, damn, you know, like you wouldn't think of that stuff. Like, oh, I'm just gonna think of like humans being trapped in pods. Like, no, I'm literally seeing everything. Like, there's so much. So with all this work, like, you know, I take out all the humans out of pods, and it's not only from Earth. Like, there are humans in other planets and realms, there are other humans who are just go into the astral realm and they're being captured and stuff. Like, lots of beings. So I just, like, get them all out, get them to safe places, and get them in, delete their traumatic thing so that they would remember things but would feel no trauma. And then I take care of this whole thing. But, like, you know, we do this one little session for 30, 40 minutes, 1 hour. And that's the experience that I have, like, you know, dealing with Greece, with reptilians, with AI, with underground bases, seeing tons of beings, like, there's a lot. And then I travel to another planet where, you know, spaceships are going through, and they're literally, it's a dumping ground for people. Like, literally just tons of people, like, thousands and thousands and thousands, and it's piled up, like, millions of people, humans, literally, and, you know, like, this dumping ground. They, like, just harvesting us, using us as cattle for whatever it needs. It's just like crazy, you know.
Yeah. Yeah. While doing that with you, it became more real to me, more clear to me, that the universe with all these different galaxies, so many galaxies and so many planets. I mean, just in our own galaxy, there's like billions of planets. That's what I heard. I didn't count them myself. That's what I heard. But there's a lot of, there's humans everywhere. There's just lots of humans. And while a lot of humans are having comfortable civilizations advance in love and peace, also there is this threat, the alien threat, non-human, that they see us as food, cattle, and resource. And they're very aggressive. And there's more than just the reptilians, but the reptilians are a big one. And it's a real deal. It's a real thing. And it's going on in the physical this physical density. And it's going on in the next universe out, so to speak, the higher vibrational rendition of this universe. And so, you know, with this much going on and things reaching a peak, my training has always told me, don't really talk about this stuff. It'll fuck people up. You know, it's similar to that. It was, I didn't get it from the government, but it's similar to that story of, don't tell the government's saying, oh, we don't want to tell anybody about the extraterrestrials because the population will go insane. They'll get all panicked and get crazy.
Yeah.
Well, I was told similar stuff by those who were teaching us. To me, you can't do that. It'll disturb the people you're sharing with. And whether that's true or not, that was 30, 40 years ago. That's not now. Right now, there's too many people writing saying, I have entity issues. Can you help me? Well, we can share with you the bigger story and the bigger picture what it's about, how involved it is, and hang on to your hat, man, because the stuff will knock your hat off. It's just like, whoa. But I believe the more you know, the better off you're going to be about it. And you can start with doing the soul contract revocation course, because you're breaking agreements with beings that you were in contact with before you got here on Earth. You can call them entities. You can call them archons. You can call them angels, ascended masters, ETs, extraterrestrials. Doesn't matter what you call them. We made these agreements. And we've been making agreements for millions and billions of years. And every time we're making agreement, it's a contract. Every time we contract, we get smaller, less able, less powerful, less aware, less knowing. So when you break a contract, you stop contracting and you're able to start expanding again your reach. Every time you contract or make a contract with somebody, you're agreeing to this. Like if you agree to be at this place at 4 o'clock, you can't be free to be somewhere else at 4 o'clock or even 3:30 or 5 o'clock, because you got to be there at four. So you got to make sure you're there at four. Look at me getting all crazy about my issues about appointments. Sorry. I was fucking sideways. But yeah, these contract agreements will contract you. So as you spot those and blow those off, you'll be getting familiar with entities. And it's like a entity handling 101. It's kind of like that. And one of the steps in the entity work, in the soul contract work, is to communicate with some of these entities, tell them to back out of your space, and tell them what you can do and what you will do if they do mess with you again. And you get more empowered regarding the entity phenomena.
Yeah.
And then another step after that, you can start recovering aspects of yourself, soul fragments. So you're learning the baby steps of the soul retrieval 101, kind of, you know, the basics on getting back aspects of yourself back. So you're getting rid of entity stuff, or entities being a kind of sentience with some sort of awareness and ability to generate thought or feeling independently. And then this comes and gets attached to you. It may be very intelligent. It may be just basically a hypnotized, brain dead old being that is relatively unconscious. And they're using its mental, emotional energy, like a little battery, a little programming in it, and the being is out to lunch, but he's here as an entity in your space, generating, let's say, anger or guilt or some emotional thing. Or it might be putting out like a loop of thought. You'll see something in your environment and you'll get this trigger, this thought all the time, loop, 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 loop. You can't stop the thought or the feeling because you think it's your own. So you have a misassignment of ownership of the thought. And so it won't go away. It's like you hear some music out of the radio and you don't like it, so you turn off the radio and you're still hearing the music. And it seems like it's coming out of the radio. You don't have any control because you don't really know the real source of it. The real source is somewhere else. You spot the real source, and then you can start working at turning it off, detaching it, getting rid of it and stuff like that. So you can get rid of these unwanted emotions and thoughts and compulsions and actions and activities doing this kind of work. It's kind of advanced, though. I'm not saying it's for everybody, but if you can see vividly, like close your eyes and see a vivid scene of an apple or something like that, Ogvila and I could probably help you with this kind of work, guided sessions and stuff like that. So over at richwest.net, we also have talk to Ogvila, talk to Rich for a consultation and stuff, and see if there's something more we can do with you and to help you with this sort of thing. And Ogvila will also help you with sessions. If you learn how to do the course, the soul contract revocation stuff, you learn how to do that, then she can give you your first sessions, walk you through it, kind of get you comfortable with doing it on your own, because it's really a course for doing it on your own. And if you take the course, you can get a consultation with me and I can help you learn how to do the steps and stages and stuff. So we have these different services and help we're giving you about the subject of entities. Thank you for listening.
Nice spiel.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. So back to you. Were some of the things you want to share more with others?
About yeah, one that came to mind, you know, like as I was talking about the plan where they were piling up people, I've seen lots of planets where really reptilians and other beings are conquering other planets, like and making it their own. So they're changing the atmosphere, they're changing the beings out there, they're changing everything. And that's what they're doing on Earth. Like, you know, I've seen them change the atmosphere on other planets, and that's probably what they're doing here on Earth with the chemtrails, causing like different chemicals and stuff to match the air and atmosphere like theirs. And when I've seen those piled up bodies, one of the things that I've noticed is that, you know, it's easy for me to scan through, see everything that's like inside their bodies, what they've eaten, what they've ate, and all this stuff, like absolutely everything, which is like crazy, but at the same time, like really impressive. And you know, what I found out is that entities and like beings are feeding or injecting or projecting entities into animals. Smaller ones, basically like nanoparticles, like super micro, where you cannot notice it. Animals, they don't notice it. It's just for them, like, okay, they're not affected by it. But that's ready for humans, so that when we consume those entities, they will be able to get inside us, find a place where they can like live and all stuff. And then when they're needed, that AI or their creators or like, you know, their higher ups can like turn on the channel and start getting them to work. So they can affect us with entities and stuff. And for us, those entities are mainly like getting us addicted to junk food. Now, I'm not saying like, hey, if you have sort of diet, like please change, go vegan or whatever. Like people will eat whatever they want to eat and eventually like it's their choice. But at the same time, like basically just what I've seen, that those who eat certain foods and like have meat and stuff, and not specifically every single meat, but like, you know, that more of those entities and that's like really affected, it's not only the emotions and energy that you get from that animal, but it's also like those entities. And when they're messing with you, we get more on that. And you know, you can eat like a burger and like it's usually known at the fast food chains and stuff, but they also have some fetuses and like dead human cells and stuff like that, like McDonald's and other places. It's proven that they have those. So if they're feeding off and getting high on adrenochrome, and we're consuming the food that also have human parts in it, aren't we doing the same on a smaller level? Like, you know, but still, like they're getting us addicted to that food. They want us like to go into that. So like they like human bodies, but at the same time they get off like really high when we're doing like shit, like when we're really fucked and we're like feeling like blah, like okay, for a few minutes when you're eating this, like, oh, it tastes good, like I'm freaking amazed by the taste and all stuff, you're happy for those few minutes. After that, like it goes downhill, like, oh, like I ate, like, so you're already feeling like tired or obese or whatever, and you have those different emotions and reactions to it. But it's also like archons, like, or you know, whoever creates the food, and like it's basically been their plan all along. Make this shit food to fuck with people so that they could get that loose from us. So it's basically they're feeding us shit so that we would feel like shit, so that they could get off on like feeling high on us. So it's a huge thing. I just like, fine, I'll get it out, but damn, it's big.
Yeah, it is big. Damn, yeah. Yeah. Also, we did some entity work and soul contract revocation with Ogvila. I did work with her on this. Your ability to communicate right now, like what you just did, how does that compare to a couple of years ago when we first started?
is it worth comparing? I was literally the person who could not talk. Like I had tons of fears. Rush and I spent the first few years through the text chat. He would be on camera, he would talk to me with Mike, and I could like basically mouth closed, and I would just type it all. And for me, like, I had lots of fears talking to people. Like when Rich came to Lithuania to see me, and we were, like, literally, he asked, like, me in the shop to, like, ask, like, some personal people, like, oh, personal staff or whatever, to get something. I literally walked up, and my body was shaking. I felt like I'm going to pass out. Like, it was that bad talking to people. And we did, like, 5-6 soul contract sessions on communication, like, my issues about it, and, like, you know, people that I'm communicating with, and how I feel about my reactions and stuff. And even after the first few sessions, after the first one, I've noticed that it's easier to talk, it's easier to ask for people and stuff. And now just look at me, like I've started like, it's probably 4 or 3 months since I have a YouTube channel. I'm making lots of videos, I'm having my own content and stuff. I'm not shouting out for 30 minutes, which is like amazing because I've never been that expressive. Like in school, it would be super hard to talk even for 2 minutes. I was like you know, damn, I'm scared. And now I'm talking for over 30 minutes to my people on YouTube and it feels great. So I'm having huge wins, like huge wins.
Wow. So get over there and get Soul Content Relocation course right away before it's gone. No, it's not gone. But yeah, but there's also an entity course that if you get the Soul Contract course, you get the entity course for free. That's the thing. I got going. So yeah. yeah, I just wanted to bring that up because you're changing greatly. Oh, today... about your one of your communication issues was something about your throat here, and then something came up to me. Let's share about that.
Let's recall what we did today. We were targeting in the past how I'm more reactive to people's opinion. Like basically, I had a hard time getting my content out. Like I would think it's not good enough and stuff. So that's the item we picked, and I found like some entities related that were picking on me and people around me and stuff. And with everything that was going on through my life and everything that I've heard and I've been experiencing, I've just been stopped. And, you know, some of the things were, like, basically causing hesitations, doubts, things like that. My throat would hurt, lock up, it's hard to talk. So those things. And, like, for me, my throat is a big thing because, like, in some of my past lives, it just happened that I was a person that I was trying to get that important information out. And as I was about to say the fact to the ruler of that realm, someone sliced my throat, and then like I was like literally laying on the ground, bleeding away, and seeing my lover killed like right in front of me, and I was like, they're suffering. So basically, I couldn't talk right like on time and stuff. And for those like it just built up through time where, it, like in this life, it was a thing that whenever I would want to say something important, my throat locks up, it hurts, I can't talk, like it's really bad. And so with the sessions I've been doing and today, like it just feels like it's opening up more, it doesn't hurt, it's freer and easier. So it's like, it's a big thing for me.
Yeah, were there some entity stuff locked into your throat or in there? I thought, did you mention that in the session today?
Just projecting. I think just projecting those things. But probably as well, like, you know, let me think about it. We clear out, like you sort of forget about those that you clear out.
Yeah. Forgive me for even asking you about. You know, no, we don't need to get attention back on it.
It's okay, but I think like from everything that I consume and the entities that were in my body, like they can target me. So wherever they are, and so I think some were in my throat. So as I'm targeting specific subject and I want to say something important, that's when they turn on, like, she's going to talk, she's going to say something, she's going to expose us, she's something important, we need to stop her. And that's where they turn on the buttons, it makes, like, my throat locks up, it starts hurting, I have, like, tons of issues getting it out, and that's, like, I open my mouth, but the words won't come out. Like, that's the thing.
Wow, yeah, well... That's not happening now, is it?
Yeah, it's like it's changing. Like it's changing big time. I'm getting like lots of wins, and you know, speaking of the Soul Contract work, like people are getting lots of benefits. Like even today or a few days ago, I got someone on my YouTube channel like commenting that, you know, they took your course, they were doing sort of stuff, and like they were dealing with people that are being affected in their life. Like really, like, there are some abusive people and like some revocations and like, you know, the work they did. And all of a sudden people are changing, they're not affected anymore, and like relationships are easier and stuff. Like it's amazing. I had some people who were like losing their sense of tasting and smelling, and after some revocations, like they got it back. Not everything, but like it got way better than it was. Like there's lots of wins, but people need to put in the work and like do it, you know, properly.
Yeah. Well, what I like about this whole subject is it expands one's awareness and understanding of the issues and the problems that humanity is having. You know, we're not, it's not us. It's, you know, we're not destroying our planet. We're not causing wars. It's not us. It's not us. It's these, it's the alien invasion force, you might call it. It's having a happy little island of loving, peaceful people. And then people, the these aggressive conquerors, they want to sneak in and take over, but they do it undercover. And so they pretend to be local people. And they maybe even mate with the locals, and they have their children who are that conqueror attitude and mindset and heart. And so you do this for a few thousand years, and you've got this loving, peaceful nation that always was and always will be of a certain species. And now it's infiltrated. You could say it's infested. It's got a disease, dis-ease, no more easy, dis-ease. And now they're going around and saying, you guys are fucked. You guys are killing each other. And they're causing the wars and the killing and stuff. And it's how these insidious beings, whether they're entities, ETs, or just the super rich power elite, doesn't matter what you call these people or these beings, this is what they do. We were could, would, was, will be again a wholesome kind of species, us, Earth. I'm not saying every planet of humans is all, anyway, without going all that away, the getting an expanded awareness of what's going on in the universe and the multiverse gives you a bigger picture of the galactic situation, civilization within our galaxy. How does our planet fit in with the rest of the planets? Intergalactic travel, galactic trade. Humans are being traded as a commodity in intergalactic trade. Slave trade, humans. Just saying. It's not hard to believe. We were doing, you know, the slave trade is going on right now on planet Earth. Human trafficking, child trafficking, but it's been going on in history. You know, it's, you know, wasn't even hidden. You know, a lot of slavery going on for thousands of years. But just saying, the more we can wake up to what's going on, the more we can find freedom, liberation from it all. We have greater choices when we do leave this plane of existence for good. You know, do you want to come back or not? There are other wholesome, wonderful realities and dimensions and universes that we can go to if we have, we know our options. And if we don't know our options, if we have limited options, limited choices, the bad guys can be giving you three choices. You got three choices here. Pick one. And none of them are good for you. And it's all a setup.
Yeah.
That's kind of how they like to play it. But, help me wrap this up or keep it going, because I'm
sure. Well, we can go for wrapping it up. I just want to say that the sort of work we're doing is really important, and I would like really recommend people to look into that. Like, you don't have to be all into revoking soul battle agreements, all into like working with mentees. You can just have a passion for getting out of body. And as you get out of body and have various experiences, you can meet all kinds of beings, learn, and get various informations, and just when you get back, you'll have more knowledge. And like, it's amazing that I can go out and find out something that's really matching everything in here, like what Rich knows, what other people know. I've never heard about it here, but I went there, I found out, I came here with the knowledge. So you can do that as well. Like, we have people like Nikola Tesla who were able to do the like astral projection and get out of body, meet other civilizations and get their technology, come back and write it down and create it. So you can do that as well. So you don't have to be all into entities or all into soul contracts or whatever, just have a passion. But there's tons of things that you can do out there. It's like, it's really important to just do that sort of work and have a different experience. So to get the better understanding of the whole multiverse, not just physical world.
Yeah. 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 We could talk on and on and on, but it's probably a good place to wrap it up.
Pretty much.
So, thank you for watching, and your comments are welcome. And, and thank you, Ogvila, for this. So we will talk to you guys later. Really appreciate it.